Hey everybody, it's Jimmy Grappone here with the CLT Life. Thanks for checking out our website and our YouTube channel. You can go to thecltlife.com for new, fresh, original content. Also, links to all kinds of resources that are all things Charlotte. You can also find our online store at thecltlife.com/shop. So I want to talk about this article that was posted on Axios Charlotte today about CATS, which is the Charlotte area's public transportation system. And they've got an article, the title is "The Extent of CATS Dysfunction Has Put Riders at Risk Amid a Culture of Silence." This is some really damning stuff here about the public transportation system here in the Charlotte area. And it's interesting because we have so many people who move here from all over the country, from big metropolitan area, big metropolises, that are known for their public transportation system. And they come here lots of times and they're kind of shocked to find that they end up having to drive everywhere just because we don't have that solid public transportation system that a lot of other places have. But here are some of the headlines here. The bus system has seen its reputation erode and ridership dwindle. Drivers often feel at risk of violence while on their routes. Last May, the light rail derailed while 24 passengers were on board because of a defect that exists on all 42 trains on the light rail system. We're also just now finding out that there's 37 light rail bridges and 6 parking decks that are overdue for inspection. Plus, CATS also needs to aggressively work to order new buses since about a third of their buses are over 12 years old, which is past the recommended usable age. And half of those, more than half of those, so more than 50, are more than 15 years old. Let's see. So they talk about a culture of silence at the CATS system, which has pervaded for years, which has led a lot of employees to not really say anything, afraid to speak up concerning issues such as delayed maintenance. So that's an issue that certainly needs to be fixed and needs to be addressed. So there's a lot of work to clean up this public transportation system here in Charlotte. Charlotte is a great city, but it doesn't have a great public transportation system. If you've ridden on the light rail or on a bus anytime recently, or if you've thought about it but decided not to for some reason, I'd love to hear your feedback and get your opinion on Charlotte's public transportation system.